Hi guys, welcome to another video. So far, pretty much most of my channel has been entirely pistols. Just a quick disclaimer as well, I keep forgetting to put this into my videos, but this is an airsoft toy, not a real firearm. None of the toys you see on my channel are real firearms, they're all airsoft toys or air guns. Yeah, like I said, pretty much all of what I've put on the channel so far has been pistols, and honestly, that is my true love. I love my pistols. However, I love some of my rifles as well. So I thought I'd share a couple of the ones I have, and if you like doing some kind of breakdown review of what I've got and what I think of it. What we've got here is the VFC BCM mcmr. This is the, I think it's the 11.5. I say I think it's the 11.5 because I actually bought this second hand. I'm not sure what it was, but from what I've looked at, it looks like it's the 11.5 model. So this is VFC's, as far as I'm aware, it's not their latest system. It doesn't have the V3 magazine or come with the V3 magazine, but it certainly has the upgraded newer V3 internals. But we'll quickly talk over it, and I'll sort of show you some ins and outs of it. So we can see here we've got these lovely BCM trays on here. Excuse all the lube, all the oil. Yeah, lovely BCM trays. One of the things which really got me interested in the rifle was just all of the trays on it were fantastic. And all of these parts are genuine BCM. Well, they're not genuine, but they are replications of BCM parts. Same with the stock, which I'm actually not that much of a fan of, but it is the BCM stock, hence BCM markings. We've also got the BCM rail, which does actually state airsoft use only on here. And then it's also a BCM flash hider here as well. So literally, it's all BCM. We've got the BCM bolt carrier as well, BCM magazine, BCM trades, and from what I understand as well, it is a BCM spec charging handle as well, which it does say on the top of it. So let's just talk a little bit about the rifle then. So like I said, I got this used. However, it's not been used. It's brand new, basically. I got a cracking deal on it, and I just couldn't turn it down. But it was my first VFC M4, and at the time, I had a GHK. And everyone raves about the GHK M4, and it is a good platform. I'm not knocking it, because it definitely is a good platform. But it just wasn't what I expected it would be for the money it was. The finish was okay, but really not brilliant. The internals as well were all steel, but they're all just cast steel. Not really high quality or high finished components, in my opinion. Really, the best thing about the GHK was the bolt carrier group and the nozzle, and potentially the magazine. They're obviously all the parts you really want to make the rifle function really well, but it just wasn't what I was expecting. And when I got hold of this, it was just blew my mind. The amount of steel parts on this as well is phenomenal, which is, as you know, what I love. Anyway, so we'll have a quick look at the magazine. This isn't the V3 magazine. As you can see, the V3 has a little switch on here for dry fire mode, which actually I really need to get one because I dry fire mine quite a lot, just messing around with them because I'm a bit of a child like that. But the VFC mags are one solid tank. The nice thing is they charge out of the way, so you don't see the fill valve, which is really good. And the top of the magazine, the whole top, is the feed lip assembly, basically. It's also got their new style gas rotor, which is floating. So essentially, while the bolt is traveling, there's a bit of a gap, and then as the hammer striker hits the valve and gas starts to come through here, the gas expansion causes the rotor to sort of push up and seal against the nozzle really well. So it's a really good idea. So these are fantastic. Hold loads of gas, really, really good. The rifle itself, as I showed you all the trades, so much steel on it. The bolt release is steel. The fire selector is steel. It is a non-ambi on this one though, which is a bit of a shame. I mean, I'm right-handed anyway, so it doesn't bother me in the slightest, but I know that some of my left-handed brethren wouldn't appreciate that. We obviously got the steel mag release as well, steel trigger. You've got the steel castle nut on the buffer tube. The back plate is steel, which is a BCM item as well. You can see the star, which also is for using a QD mount there as well. Bolts on the front here are steel that hold the rail on. Flash hider is steel. Obviously pins are steel, and the bolt carrier is steel. So loads of steel on this thing. So let's break it down quickly and we'll have a look inside and see what we've got. So here we go, here's the lower receiver. And again, check out those nice deep trades. I know I keep going on about it, but they just look so good. Anyway, this is apparently the latest from VFC, their new sort of fire control group. Now, one thing I will mention is that all the internal parts here are steel. They're fantastically made, greatly, improved upon over the previous generations. I remember the first VFC I really looked at AR-wise, it was all pot metal internals. I think I remember watching Bada Bing's video on the 417 and all the internals were pot metal as well. I could be wrong there, but we've got all nice steel internals here. They're nicely made, really good. If you watch the Red Wolf video on this, Red Wolf Airsoft, it talks about the striker for the magazine valve. They've basically reduced the internal parts here and made a much simpler system, which is much more reliable. Now, one thing that my rifle came with, which I'm not sure is stock, so hopefully someone in and there can help me and give me the correct information for this, is mine came with this horrible thing inside. This is one of the, from what I understand, the 416 or the early buffers. And I hate it. It's horrible. It weighs a load. It's got a big old spring inside and a big metal weight. This is a steel weight that shimmies back and forth. It's supposed to give great recoil, and it probably does, but it's just unnecessary. The problem is as well, is this small surface area beats the hell out the inside of the buffer tube. So with all of my ARs, I fit, I'll take this one out, you'll see, real steel buffers. These aren't like super expensive. You can get them various different places pretty cheap, but the way you can tell if it's a real one, and this is probably quite a cheap Chinese version of it, but at the end of the day it is just a buffer, is that you've got, you can hear inside there, we've got weights that go back and forth. You can buy super lightweight ones of these for airsoft guns, which is obviously great because it improves gas efficiency. But one thing I found with the steel bolt ARs, whether it be GHKs or whatever, changing to steel bolt, you tend to get bolt bounce. And with bolt bounce, you then get misfeeds. This weighted buffer solves that. And it was designed for the real steel to stop bolt bounce. So using it in airsoft makes perfect sense. Now, again, I'm not sitting here saying that I am the be-all and end-all and know everything about this, because I don't. But I tried a few different solutions to stop it double feeding and to stop it from, you know, doing what it was doing, which was either, you know, beating the hell out of the inside of the buffer tube, or just bolt bouncing to hell and double feeding and jamming. And literally, I bought one of these, fit it in, and it just stopped. It was perfect. So if you haven't got one, get yourself one of these. They're fantastic. This is the stock spring, from what I understand. Now again, I did buy it used, even though I can't see how it's been used at all. But that spring is pretty tough, actually. If you want to use it in winter time, you probably want to get a winter spring for it, because it is pretty tough. But all of your pins are obviously steel. Your bolt catch is one single piece and is steel. Obviously, like I said, all of the internal hammer parts are steel. The fire selector is steel. As with proper ARs, you can't put the gun into safe when the hammer is dropped, which is correct. But yeah, that's the lower. And it's fantastic. We'll talk about the trigger shortly, but it's just as good as it sounds. So let's look on the upper then. So here's your upper receiver. As you can see, I've got a clone Romeo 5 SIG sight on it at the moment, just because it's lightweight. And the one thing I will say about this entire rifle, when you pick one up for the first time, oh my God, is it lightweight. It is, considering the amount of steel on here and the steel bolt, it is crazy lightweight for a GBBR. And to be fair, you could lighten it further if you wanted to, remove some of the steel, like the steel flash hider and stuff like that, and you can drop the weight down pretty easy. The main mass is, of course, as you expected, the bolt carrier group, which has got some nice BCM markings on it. As you can see, this one's a bit oily. Got some grease on here. I don't actually use grease internally on my guns usually. But what you will find with ARs is that you get the twang of the spring in the buffer tube. And my dad, who used to mess around with real steel rifles back in the day when you could own them, told me a neat little trick, which was to put some grease on the spring inside the buffer tube, and you just completely deadens that sound. You don't get the sort of twang from the spring anymore. So that's what I did. But the rest of the gun, I just use some of Waldo Customs lubricants, which I believe you can get in various different airsoft sites and places now. But that's fantastic stuff, so get yourself some of that. But this, like I said, is a steel bolt carrier group. It is CNC steeled as well, unlike the GHK, which the version 1s were just cast and were really rough. This one is CNC steel. Nozzle is pretty tough. It's got a real tough return spring on it. One of the things you look for quite a lot of the time with these, if you can, is look for a really good piston seal. So covering up the inlet and outlet ports and pushing the nozzle in, we get a really good seal there, which just means you're going to get great compression here, which is going to throw the bolt back with some force. Unlike the GHK though, it is a single O-ring, which I quite like the GHK for that, where it had two O-rings and it had great compression. But this runs perfectly as is. One of the nice things with the new VFCs as well, I don't know whether this is just my gun or whether they all came like it, but you can see inside the nozzle there is an Allen key head. You can adjust the FPS by putting an Allen key in the end of the nozzle and tightening or loosening, which is fantastic. Why all gas guns don't have this out the factory is beyond me. It's something that really they should all have, because, you know, depending on what gas you're using, they can shoot a bit hot. So that's the bolt carrier group. We've got the BCM gunfighter charging handle, which is sort of a butterfly style. Not sure if this is the same as real steel, I doubt it, but it's a nice thing to have. Looking at the rest of the upper, you've obviously got your dust cover, which is just your standard style dust cover, nothing interesting there. One of the nice things with the BCM as well is it uses the VFC system for adjusting your hop. And we can see down here, there's an Allen key head down there. You use an Allen key in the end of here and you can adjust the hop from there. The 416 has the gas block at the end where you can turn that to adjust it, which again is fantastic. But this is also quite a good system. It's very oily in there. I probably need to give that a bit of a clean. But we can see it's got this, and you can just about make it out, the VFC blue hop rubber, which actually works really well. Very good. And we've got this faux failure button, they call it, the forward assist. But the wear inside is pretty good. You know, there's a little bit of wear, but nothing too bad considering that's a steel bolt driving home all the time. The rail is fantastic as well. Really sharp. It appears to be anodized as well. As far as I can tell, the receivers, if they're painted, they're painted really well. But I suspect they might be anodized as well. But the rail, I would say, almost certainly feels anodized. As far as I can tell, the outer barrel is aluminium. But to be honest with you, you don't need it to be steel. At the end of the day, it's only there for support and looks, really. The bit you're going to see is obviously the flash hider, which is steel. The BCM mcmr comes with these rail covers which clip in, which is BCM air. Some people like them, I personally hate them, so I took them out straight away. And you get one rail which you can fit on any side, and obviously the rest of this is just M-lock. But yeah, there's your upper receiver. So we'll get the gun back together. And I'll show you a video, once I've got it back together, of what I was talking about with minimal or no bolt bounce with that buffer in there. With the other buffer, this horrible thing, which I think from what I've searched up, is what you get with the 416. So it's like a V1 or V2 design. These are terrible. Bolt bounce is really bad. So we'll get the gun back together and we'll do a couple of little test shots so you can see it running. Okay, so we've got it back together now. Just to show, it is clear, there is nothing in the chamber, and mag is clear as well. So I don't know what gas is in this. I haven't gassed it for probably 6 months. I've no idea how much gas is in it. We might have to regas it at some point, but we'll just slap it in and see what happens. The bolt bounce I was talking about, I should have included the video just before this so you can see the middle bolt bounce, but the bolt travel is super snappy considering this is a steel bolt, and because the rifle is so light, the recoil is, it's impressive for what it is. So let's just drop that bolt home. Now these mags don't have the ability to dry fire, so I'm gonna have to hold the bolt catch in, so that's why I've got my hand around the other side here. But we're in semi, so see, super snappy, locks back every time. Let's go into auto. Now I will say it doesn't run great in auto. I think that's just because it's got a really heavy bolt, but it still runs okay, but not the best. You can see we're running a lot of gas coming out of the chamber here. At the end of the day, we don't really use full auto in airsoft really, and I really mess around with it just in semi-auto. But, you know, it's there if you want to use it. So there we go. There's the BCM MCMR. I don't want to go into massive detail on this because, I mean, it's not really a review. I mean, I'm probably going to put it down as a review, but it's just my thoughts on it. Personally, it's one of my favourites. I actually got it out the other day and messed around with it, and I forgot just how good it was. Really light, really responsive, feels really tactile. The trigger reset is just fantastic. So we've got no take up whatsoever there. It's right on the wall. So light squeeze, a little bit of creep, and then it drops. Probably £4. And the reset, straight away and really crisp. My only criticism, I would say, is the way they've designed the lower is so light that you really hear the hammer hit when just dropping the hammer down. So I don't know whether that's going to do damage in the end, but it's really loud. In fact, if I put my finger up inside and just try and cushion the sound, it's nowhere near as bad. But yeah, fantastic rifle, love it. Any questions at all, fire away in the comments. What do you think? Do you have one of these? Have you messed around with them much? Would you have one of these? Would you choose something else? This is obviously just my opinion. I'm not really a big skirmisher. I tend to just sort of shoot in the garden. So you might say it's terrible, but I'm keen to hear your comments. So fire away, and I'll see you in the next video.